I haven't been upstairs. If I did, I would have brought it.
I'll be done with this in about an hour. Did not think it would take this long, but the more you go over and go over and go over it, revisit the same colors again, and the more you see the little areas that need to be hit, to bring out more detail, give a more finished look to it. I won't stop until I see that it's when I'm drawing from other photos, I don't stop till I see that everything is as exact as it's represented in the photo. I mean, as close as can be. Obviously, when you're drawing from another photo, you're able to do it faster because it eliminates the thought process of drawing out of your own imagination, which requires more work. So yeah, this is easier. But there's also the challenge of trying to replicate what you see. There's definitely skill required. It adds a layer of difficulty that you don't get, because when you're drawing from your own imagination, you put down what you want. You put the lines, the placement of the lines and all the details where you want them, and then you leave it be. With this, you have to replicate exactly what you see. So it's a different challenge that presents itself. It can take longer because you don't want to stop until you get it to it's like the picture. But I like it because I can relax part of my mind. It's like putting it together like a jigsaw puzzle, you know? It's a good form of meditation and relaxation. Just let your mind go and you know, you remove your thoughts, you know? Yeah, it can be relaxing and enjoyable. But I also like drawing from my imagination too. That's especially creating my own things. That's a different kind of a joy that comes from that. Different kind of satisfaction. When you create your own thing, that's why I get into this. Not to replicate photos. It's fun to do. I like to do it, but I learn from it. It's mainly for the purposes of learning how to draw different things. But so that I can draw from my imagination in the future without having to look at something. That's really why I'm doing this. To build that catalog in my mind of different things like this right here. I've drawn this before, Indian headdress. So I'm learning how to draw that kind of pattern of clothing so that I can do it in the future from my imagination because I've already done it a couple of times, which is important for comic books. So I'm really at the beginning stages of my drawing education. I'm a little bit old to be starting fresh. Yeah, I've been drawing on and off my whole life, but only now have I really taken a serious approach, more of a learning approach, fundamental approach, because I want shit to look right. I want it to look, when I do comic books, I want that shit to look correct, you know what I mean? So it takes a good eye, you know. Not everybody has that ability to focus and see, you know, what's there, and to draw it. Baffling is, it seems easy, but not everybody can do it, or has the patience. I got into drawing because I grew up a Jehovah's Witness. I couldn't play sports in school. Couldn't participate in things that were considered worldly. In fact, they even frown on comic books. They say you're really not supposed to read comic books. So that's one thing. But I always did. Growing up, I read comic books. Doesn't make any sense because they can watch movies, you know, and that are produced by the world, but they frown on comic books, which is, you know, makes no sense at all. That's cults for you.
Very proud of that because most stuff in the world, you know, Your bet, bro. Keep my sanity.
Scotty and Fernando are bringing me back to the front house.
Yeah, I got that on camera too. What happened?
Oh, you did?
Yeah, because I filmed my drawing and it caught it. Light cerulean blue coming up next. Another layer of blue. Thank you. very proud of this piece. You do something like this, it's like, thank God for photocopy machines and cameras, so I can have a copy for myself. It's nothing like having the original. He bought me rollerblades for Christmas, so that's, I spent $50 on them, big five, so I was like, okay, I know I'm gonna have to get you something now. And then he took me out and helped me to learn how to rollerblade, which nobody's ever done before. That one made me jump a little bit. A little bit darker than cloud blue. Okay. It could be a loincloth, it could be a kilt too, like the Scottish wear kilts. This is probably more like something like a kilt. Well, I didn't wear an ID in his life. He's really old, too. Said he just got one. Let's see. Great. Hardcore camera.
Yeah.
Thinking this image is taking him a video game or some shit like that, which is a good idea. I thought about like just pausing it on a video game, an image like from Mortal Kombat, and just drawing that. Because I chose the image, or I could position the image. It's like a Marlowe reference that you can move around. But I don't have a video game console right now. I
can use my phone, I guess.
So while I don't get to keep this drawing for myself, I can put it in my portfolio.
No, the refrigerator. It wasn't the freezer. It wasn't only water.
And I was going to build a better portfolio. Can
I pull it to it?
Yes.
Like for soup.
It's like if you do your best and you put in the time, do your best, put in the time, produce good work, and you shouldn't have any regrets or errant thoughts of, oh, am I doing good enough? Why can't I make any progress? Maybe you're not putting in enough time. Increasing your skill. Helps to be good at something. I think it helps to be good at something. Helps me personally to be more content with my life. To, like something to show, you know? Something to pursue, otherwise you're just drifting aimlessly. Carefree and happy, no worries in the world to concern me. Come to the end of this, something that's taken this long, like toward the end. Oh man, that's such a good feeling. Relief, like, hell yeah, accomplishment. The tribe will accept me now into its village. You dealt it, smelled it, dealt it. I like drawing when there's other people, especially like drawing with other artists in a creative environment. But well, that in itself, just drawing with another, that's what creates it. That's what makes it creative. Thank you. Indigo blue, indigo blue, indigo blue. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Get done here. I'm gonna fucking organize all my colors according to Indigo Blue. This is PC 901. Sitting on the third tray. I'm gonna organize them numerically. I'm gonna see. When I got them new, they were all organized according to the color spectrum. And I dropped the whole box off the second story upstairs and the color pencils went everywhere. So once I organize them numerically again according to the numbers, I will then be able to see whether they are organized that way according to the color spectrometer. A good dark blue here. Almost, well, it's the first time I spit on it. Oops. Extra sugar free gum. Almost a black. Works on this. Almost indigo blue. Indigo, that's my favorite weed. Not indica, and the indigo. It's like a blue colored weed. Like this color. Almost like a dark green. Greenish blue. Bigger than this, more stable. But I am not working, so I don't have the money for this. Talk my mom into buying it for me. She's already bought me a bunch of art supplies. Earlier in me, this part where I'm drawing right now, this would have been like, the old me would have been like, I'd just pass over this or try to like, you know, make it all black or some shit. better than adding life. But just adding the smallest little line or detail can really like profoundly add to the drawing and change it. Especially when drawing the face, just tweaking the little lines of the face, the mouth, or whatever, can contribute or take away to the expression immensely. Just small little changes, something I learned or noticed. But the important point is to tweak it in the right direction. If you keep tweaking it and tweaking it, you know, in the wrong direction, and then erasing it and read, that's overworking it. You want to
what we're working, but in the right direction. That's why reverence is so important. So if you don't know what it looks like, and you keep fucking tweaking it and moving it, it's good to experiment like that. If you're trying to work on a finished drawing, it's gonna fucking drawing it. You know, spend a lot of unnecessary time. But to each his own. I mock his laugh when he's here. It's, you know. If I mock him when he's not here, that's kind of like. And I guess that means I really don't like. Only good fun when they're there and they do it when they're behind their back. You mock him? I think that means you don't like him. She doesn't bother me. Just saying.
Hi.
Oh, I don't have one that's upstairs. I don't feel like going right now. It's upstairs. Yeah. I'll, give me a few minutes. Give me like 15 minutes. I'm trying to finish this up. All right.
Thank you, man.
Yep.
We both have a ride Monday. Oh,
yeah,
Wilson.
Using this color, I realized why they call it indigo blue, that strain of weed, because it's like a greenish blue. Before I thought it was just like a blue. I was seeing this. There's a blue tint to the green weed, basically. Learning from life without reading a book by Jack Handy. I never thought I could learn so much from colored pens. What it taught me about the topography of landmass is simply astonishing. For instance, dichotomous earth, my favorite colored pencil, brought into submission the fault lines of the equatorial and stereal ethereal of the Contagious Madarius, a cannabis cofanibus, a friend. Oh my god, cannabis. I'm not even going to like weed. I'll leave that for Snoop Dogg to glorify. So that we could all wish that was Snoop Dogg. We suffer in the rehabilitation program. Aquamarine. Indicatory of the water. Are you done yet, for Christ? No, but I want to get that guy a cigarette so he doesn't have to suck. So I'm going to try to push it along here. Thanks, guy. That needs... Not really that kind of one, but I hate to see him so. He needs one. You don't. I've never said that to somebody asking for a cigarette. I need one. Like, I've never said to somebody, like Will just came up to you and said, "That's all right," because she's hooked me up in the past with cigarettes. But you said, like, "I need a cigarette, man." Like, I've never added to somebody and said, "I need a cigarette." You know what I'm saying? I said, "Can I give you a dollar for a cigarette? Or can I have a-?" And it's like, "I need a cigarette." Like, no, you don't need a cigarette.
lines a cigarette? Oh! Well, I suppose if he needs one. Get him the cigarette and he's going to die. In that case, I don't think I should get him. I want him dead. I want him dead, so I'm not going to do this.
Chose to take shortcuts in his drawing so that he could get his wizardry. Because
I'm not going to restart this video, and I want to finish on the video. I told him 15 minutes. I'm at an hour. So
do 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 do.
The greatest musician known to man.
David Lillerman pronounced him astonishingly at the top of his game with Rolling Stone magazine.
I listen to him daily while I'm neglecting my children or whatever.
Na na ni 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 na na ni 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 ni
adjusts tie. I watch so many David Letterman. Every night I watch David Letterman, dude. See, Leno's not even funny. Like, Letterman's funny. Jay Leno's a fucking mainstream people appealing, mainstream appealing playing it safe kind of guy. Because he's got a huge card collection he gets to kind of sacrifice at the cost of making the executive. Antsy, shall I say? I am almost done. It has taken me quite literally thousands upon thousands of years, yes. I once told myself that, yeah, I'm going to do all this preliminary work on the comic book thing with all my sketchings I would do. And then, like, in the last 3 weeks of my life, I would just, like, put out this comic book. Before I died, and it would just be like complete and like awesome. I like stepped into high gear in the last year. Produced nothing up to that point in like the last 3 weeks of my life. Bam! Here you go. Thank you very much. Enjoy. He's dead. We need more issues.
What's worse than death?
Pain. Severe pain.
What's worse than death? What am I 22 minutes. Holy cow, holy cow. Let's start at the top.
Hit this guy's face up. Quiet, please. Trying, you don't want to fuck up his face. Believe it or not, as cliche as that sounds, it's fucking true. Anything that can stop me from getting Will his cigarette, it's getting his face right. Black rescued me. I suddenly spent more time on it because I saw what it was doing to the drawing. It was really necessary, I would say, to come this far into life. You know what I mean? From where I talk and from where, like, Will could take a back seat. I'm kind of busy right now, dude. I can't be going again. I didn't make you feel like, something about him would make you feel like guilty for making complaints. I don't know, because I have to do this. Black, save the drawing again. Learn a trick when drawing. Not a trick, but learn it. You don't always have to. People don't have to have the corners of their mouth turned up for them to be smiling, you know what I mean? Is learning piece, is that your armoire, pieces of furniture, oh, your dyna hutch, your Alcott, my underwear, establish some borders there. Just be on that meth, I would hear people's voices all the time responding to my thoughts. And be like, that shit would piss me. I'm like, did you hear that? Fuck. You didn't hear that? More annoying than a pompous, unseen voice fucking taunting you, This shit is annoying, I'm not kidding. I'm like, you don't know who the fuck, you want to just kill everybody. So you end up just taking it on everybody. Shading. I think I've ever done a more complete drawing for somebody for free. Yourself, if this picture was created, which I think it was computer generated from a video game, so I don't even think this was created, but if it was, did it take that person as long as it's taken me? Finish this today. Call it quits here. I'll give this guy a cigarette.